on Triple M, This Day in Rock. Fridge and Washer City, winter sale on now.
It's the 9th of June, 1962, and Ray Charles hits number one on the US singles chart with I Can't Stop Loving You. Bob Dylan records Mr. Tambourine Man today in 1964. He recorded 14 other original songs that same day as well. The Byrds later recorded a version of the song and took it to number one in both the US and the UK. The Masters Apprentices reached their peak at number 7 on the Aussie singles chart today in 1970 with Turn Up Your Radio. It was a protest song against the record ban at the time, which banned Aussie artists from the radio airwaves. The pay-for-play dispute between commercial radio stations and six major record labels resulted in major UK and Aussie pop songs being refused airplay, but some defied the ban, and this song was a popular choice by some of the DJs. Elvis Presley made history today in 1972 by performing four sold-out shows at New York's Madison Square Garden. The shows were recorded and became the album Elvis as Recorded at Madison Square Garden. Among those who attended were Bowie, Art Garfunkel, Bob Dylan, members of Led Zeppelin, John Lennon, and George Harrison. Elvis had a huge influence on the Beatles, especially George Harrison.
It had an incredible impact upon me just because I'd never heard anything like it. I mean, coming from Liverpool, we didn't really hear the very early Sun records. The first record I can remember hearing was probably the big hit by the time it got across the Atlantic. It was Heartbreak Hotel, Heartburn Motel, as Elvis called it.
The Rolling Stones released their album Some Girls today in 1978. The album cover featured the Stones in drag alongside select female celebrities in lingerie ads. The cover immediately ran into trouble when Lucille Ball, Farrah Fawcett, Liza Minnelli, Raquel Welch, and the estate of Marilyn Monroe threatened legal action. Cyndi Lauper took over the number one spot on the US singles chart for 2 weeks today in 1984 with Time After Time. The number one album across Oz today 34 years ago in 1987 was the Crowded House self-titled debut album. While over in the UK, Whitney Houston reigned on the singles chart with I Wanna Dance With Somebody. And Australia continued to invade the US charts today in 1988 with four songs in the top 40. The Church's Under the Milky Way at number 31, New Sensation by INXS at number 30, at 29, Beds Are Burning by The Oils, and at number 28 was Electric Blue by Icehouse. The Grease Mega Mix hit number one across Oz today in 1991. After a fight with her NFL star boyfriend, Andre Rison, today in 1994, TLC singer Lisa Left Eye Lopez douses Rison's tennis shoes with lighter fluid, sets them on fire in a bathtub. The fire quickly melts the plexiglass tub, then catches onto the frame of the house, burning down Rison's $2 million mansion to the ground. Lopez from TLC is charged with first-degree arson and had a five-year probation with a $10,000 fine. Today in 1998, 25-year-old Oasis singer Liam Gallagher and Simply Red singer Mick Hucknall, who was celebrating his 38th birthday, were involved in a brawl at a London hotel. Gallagher took issue with some things that Hucknall said about the band Oasis in a recent interview. Hucknall threw Gallagher against the wall before security arrived. The Library of Congress announced that 25 culturally significant recordings would be preserved in a special sound archive in the national recording industry, and the list included The Who's My Generation. Don't
try and dig what we all say.
And that's it for This Day in Rock, the 9th of June. If you're having a birthday, have a fantastic day of celebrations. You share the same birthday as Johnny Depp. Now, you thought he was an actor. Well, he is. But he's also a muso from way back and plays guitar on songs by Oasis, Aerosmith, Iggy Pop and Patti Smith. He also founded the rock group The Hollywood Vampires with Alice Cooper and Joe Perry. In the 90s, he teed up with Flea from the Red Hot Chili Peppers and Sex Pistols guitarist Steve Jones, and also starred in film clips for Tom Petty, Lemonheads, and Paul McCartney. He turns 58 today.